Yes, here we are again with a very sad Telecaster neck from the year 2002. It's back bowed this way. Actually, that would be forward bow. Sorry for the incorrect nomenclature. It's just bent the wrong direction, and it had the old, what do they call this, biflex with the walnut plug, and that's supposed to allow you to use the truss rod in both directions, but when they went the direction to take this out of it, the walnut plug popped out. Well, okay. Not the end of the world, but someone, not going to name names, decided to replace the walnut plug, and they got a new one, and they stuck it in there with Gorilla Glue, and basically glued the whole truss rod adjustment. I couldn't even find the hex head. I couldn't find it in there. I looked in there. I went, what happened? Where? What? When? How? Okay. So, that can be replaced at a later date. We're not going to worry about that at all. In fact, we're going to just loosen that off for now, because it's not doing what we want it to do anyway. It does turn. It does straighten the neck, but not in the right direction. So we're gonna get the old heat press out, give it a go. There's a lot of interest about how to make one, how to build one. So I'm gonna jig it up, and while it's cooking, I'll talk about all the parts and why and how and where. So what's gonna happen is I'm gonna mechanically push the neck the direction we'd like it to go, tighten the truss rod, and then heat it up with this beam that gets warm. Part of it, getting this right, you know, my good friend Mike was giving me, you know, he said it's important to, it's where you put, right? It's like where we bend it is important. So it's important to try to figure out where it's bent the most. And I can just sort of eyeball that. And we're looking at 7th, 8th fret. So what we'll do, I got to get my box of stuff. But what we'll do is we're going to put a spacer there. Put the heat press on there and pull the neck that direction. Tighten the truss rod and cook it. Then I'll talk about how to build one if you're feeling brave. If you're feeling brave. Okay, so this is the power supply. Everything is DC. This came off of Amazon. It's a 30 volt 10 amp power supply. HANMATEK. So, you know, that's easy to look up. Once I get this clamped up and cooking, oh look, I got my little spacer there. That's just a piece of hardwood with a bit of leather there to protect the fingerboard. Let's clamp it up. Oh, the clamps I made, that's part of what I'm trying to perfect, because clamps are clamps. These are kind of brutally steampunk, but they do the job. Clamps are clamps. Okay, we're all clamped up, and I know the camera doesn't do this justice and sort of distorts things, but I have pushed this thing into the other smiley face that we'd like to see and tightened the hell out of the truss rod. Let's cook it. So physics says hot air rises, heat radiates, but When I tell you about how this is constructed, you'll understand that there is a hot side and a space side in there. I'm going to start cooking, and then I'll talk about the technical baloney that someone might care about if they were going to actually make one of these. So what I got is this, once again, Amazon cheapo heat sensor thing with a little probe. It's not that critical as to how warm the beam gets. It's more critical about how warm the wood actually gets. So my good buddy Mike Z, who has an original heat press thingamajiggy made by ARIA, Area Japan. We believe they made it because they had to correct all the shitty guitars they built. But anyway, those things are gone the way of the dodo. I looked for one on eBay, over $400 US for some thing that's really old. So then I was begging Mike, I said, well, can we take yours apart and look inside? And he went, oh, no, we're not doing that. And he's right about that. And we'll break it and then it won't work. So I talked to him about temperature. 135 degrees Fahrenheit. All right. So I had to do, it was a lot of research. It was more research than it was making this. So we'll do, hey, wait a minute. Hey, Siri.
Mm-hmm.
What's 135 Fahrenheit in Celsius?
135 degrees Fahrenheit is 57.2 degrees Celsius.
Okay, there you go. The heaters that I installed inside that piece of aluminum box, 1.5 by 3/4, 1/8 wall thickness. I'll talk about how I built that. It's these things, and they're all off Amazon. These work on 12 volts, right? But the cool thing about them is they create 70 degrees C. No more, no less. And after a little bit of fooling around and guesstimation, once they're mounted into that channel, and I'll explain how I did that in a minute, and we, you know, take away the loss of radiant heat and so on and so forth and distance away from the actual beam to the wood, I'm right in that temperature range that was recommended. So that's that. The other thing is the power supply. If we vary the voltage, we can vary the temperature, right? Like I said, at 12 volts, they produce 70 C. You can wiggle it up and down a bit. I've cranked these up to 24 volts. They don't blow up or cook or anything. Okay, I got to pause for a minute and think about what I'm going to do. Oh, I'm going to tell you how I actually built the beam, right? There's two of those in there. Okay, so I'm there. The temperature is in the zone. We're going to let this bake for an hour. And then we'll talk about making one. So I showed you the power supply. 30 volts, 10 amps. I showed you the heater. I'll try and put a link in the description where you get that on Amazon. It's a 12 volt heater. It does 70 C. Alrighty. Okay, so I'll take the shroud off for a minute. Okay, so inside that piece of aluminum box, right, 1.5 by 3/4, is two of these, plus a piece of aluminum flat bar in there to take up the space that these don't occupy, so they're not floating around or banging around in there. And what I use to adhere it all together with is RTV high temperature silicone, which is good up to 600 degrees Fahrenheit. So I think we're safe. And that's like automotive department. They used for making gaskets and stuff like that for things in motors to get warm. so that's that. So what I did was I took the piece of aluminum flat bar, and I go a little wider here so you can picturize my bad explanation. So I took two of these, and then I took the piece of aluminum flat bar that's the same length as that box, sliced it in the middle, took the RTV, glued it to two halves of that, and then from each end glued in a bunch of RTV silicone and pushed those in, side it. That's why we have two sets of wires coming out, one each side. And that's what I did. And a lot of testing and experimentation, and so the research was the toughest part. Like, I knew what I wanted to make, but the aluminum metal stock, that's nothing. You can get that at the metal supermarket, or, you know, metal suppliers. That's scrap from work. That goes in the scrap barrels. So it's like no love lost there. So power supply, two of these, some aluminum flat bar, some aluminum box, some RTV silicone. The clamps, like I said, clamps are clamps, and I'd like to perfect something slightly different, maybe better, but, you know, I was just fooling around at work. That's a couple of the guys helped me out in the machine shop because I was busy doing other shit, and I went, you know, this will make a really good freaking clamp. And it does. But what I need to do is make some wider versions, and then I need to make, if you use this on an acoustic, where the neck is connected to the guitar, you need to get in the sound hole. So there's a something like that, but a little bit bigger. Let's put it back under its blankie. And let it cook for another hour. Well, folks, I quit this kind for tonight. We turn it off. We just let it cool on its own. And I'll take the clamps off tomorrow and see if we won. Just a rule, don't give up after one heat press. Sometimes it takes a couple of rounds. But hey, you saw what I saw. You know what I don't know. All the good links to things are below. Big shout out to everybody who cares, my patrons, Facebook group people, subscribers, Twitter people, friends and family, everybody. Be safe, be good to each other. Cheers, folks.